In the event of a flat tire, first, make sure you're parked on a firm, level surface, safely away from traffic. Avoid ice or slippery areas. Turn the ignition off, turn the hazard lights on, and set the parking brake. If at all possible, lock the front and rear of the wheel diagonally opposite the jacking position. For example, if the right front tire is damaged, lock the left rear tire. You'll find the jack and jack handle stowed beneath a cover in the cargo area's rear storage bin. Remove jack handle components 1, 2, and 3 from storage. You'll find the spare tire stowed underneath the rear of the vehicle, held in place by a cable winch mechanism. To remove the spare, fit the assembled jack handle over the winch drive nut in the jack storage area. Turn the jack handle counterclockwise until the spare tire reaches the ground with enough slack to let you pull the spare out from beneath the vehicle. Raise the spare tire upright with the tread on the ground, then tilt the retainer and pull it through the center of the wheel. Then, winch the assembly back up into place. Now, go ahead and loosen, but do not remove the lug nuts. Turn them one turn counterclockwise, with the wheel still on the ground. Next, place the jack at the lift area closest to the flat tire. Do not raise the vehicle until you are sure the jack is fully engaged. Turn the jack screw clockwise to firmly engage the jack saddle with the lift area of the sill flange. Now you are ready to raise the vehicle. Turn the jack screw clockwise until the tire just clears the surface and you've got enough clearance to install the spare tire. Remember, minimum tire lift provides maximum stability. Okay, now go ahead and remove the lug nuts and wheel. Set the spare on the vehicle with the valve stem facing out. Damage can occur if the spare tire is mounted incorrectly. Reinstall the lug nuts with the cone-shaped end toward the wheel, then lightly tighten them clockwise. Now, turn the jack screw counterclockwise to lower the vehicle and remove the jack. Once on the ground, you can finish tightening the lug nuts. Alternate lug nuts until each one has been tightened twice. Maximum effort should be used for this final tightening. It's always a good idea to have the tightness checked with a torque wrench by an authorized dealer or at a service station. Lastly, secure the tire, jack, and tools in their proper locations, and you're ready to go. This video is not intended to take the place of your owner's manual. For complete details and other important safety information, please see your owner's information.